Good morning. It is good to be with you in worship again today. The prophet Micah says these words to the people of Israel and to us as well. He has shown you, O mortal, what is good. And what does the Lord require of you? To act justly and to love mercy and to walk humbly with your God. Today, more than ever, we consider what it means to hear the cry of the needy, to give voice of those who have been oppressed, and to seek those who have been harmed and forgotten. We will hear of an amazing ministry that is happening in another part of the world. And I know that you will be inspired and encouraged and seek ways to support not only this ministry, but many ways that we come together to seek and serve in the name of Jesus. So would you join with me in worship? Sovereign God, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You created the plants and trees and water that nurture and nourish, and you declared it very good. You created fish and birds and mammals in a perfect balance, and you declared it very good. You created us in the diversity of your image, and you declared it very good. Would you pray with me? Merciful and just God, we gather here this morning, each of us with many concerns in our hearts. Our hearts are concerned with the systems of injustice which strip people of their dignity and their very lives. Help us to be those who seek peace with justice, who would fight for those who are oppressed, offer voices for the voiceless and dignity for all humankind. Be with us this day and guide our steps toward a more just world. In your name we pray. Amen. Now would you join with me as we open in songs of praise and worship.
springs a fountain filled with blood drawn from Emmanuel's veins, and sinners plunged beneath that flood lose all their guilty stains, lose all their guilty stains, lose all their guilty stains, and sinners plunged beneath that flood lose all. Dying thief rejoice to see that fountain in his day, and there have I the rise, he washed all my sins away, washed all my sins away. Sins away, and there have I the rise, he washed all my sins away. Dear dying lamb, thy precious blood shall never lose its power to some church of God be saved to sin no more, be saved to sin no more, be saved to sin no more, to all the ransom church of God be saved sin no more. Ever since by faith I saw the stream thy flowing wounds supply, redeeming love has been my theme and shall be till I die, shall be till I die, and shall be till I die. Redeeming love has been my theme, and shall be till I die.
Well, welcome. Welcome to our time of online worship. I'm glad you're here today, whether you have been with us all along during this period of change and transformation into a new way of worshiping for a period of time. And I welcome also our guests, those who have joined us since this time of being together online and have joined us today as well. It is good to be here. It is good to stay connected. It is good to continue hearing from the Word of God. And so I know today that you will be encouraged and strengthened in His Word as well. I also want to update you just briefly to let you know that our leadership board has adapted a plan of re-engagement. So over the next few weeks, we will be phasing out that plan in four phases, and the timing we know of some of it, and some of it is still up in the air as we get more information. But here's what I know. This will be, I hope, our last week of online-only worship. Next week and the week following, we will plan on worshiping outdoors here at the church. And this way we can be safe and social distance, and we can sing and give praise to God, and we can be together. We will, of course, provide still a way of an online presence, so those of you who are only able to connect with us that way will be able to as well. And so I thank you for your patience in this time, and as we move to the next phase of gathering together over the next couple of weeks. I would also ask today that you would consider giving, what it means to give. This week in our study by Max Licato, You'll Get Through This, we've been looking at the life of Joseph. And Joseph was a great steward for the nation of Egypt. And he had filled the storehouses over a period of 7 years, knowing that there was a famine coming. And when the time came and there was need, he opened the doors in the storehouses so that people could be fed. That is our call as well as Christians. It is to give because we have been generously given to. And so I ask you to consider your gifts today. You can give online. You can mail in your checks, or you can leave them at the church in our Dropbox as well. I hope that you would consider how God is calling you to support the ministries of Ortonville United Methodist Church by your tithes.
Good morning. It's good to be back here at Ortonville United Methodist Church and sit behind the piano, which I love to do. Today I'd like to sing for you a song. Is called I Am Not Alone. This song reminds me that God is always with us. He won't forsake us. He won't leave us in our sorrows, especially during these tough times that we're facing right now. We just need to remember that our God is an amazing God, and He is always with us. And just remember, we're not alone.
pray with me. God of justice and peace, we know that you created us in the diversity of your image, but still at times we refuse to see you reflected in the face of our neighbor who lacks adequate health care, who experiences hunger, who doesn't have a home, or one or many who are hurt by injustice. We often don't see your image in the face of our neighbor who has a different skin tone, who worships in a different tradition, who speaks in a language we don't understand. God, forgive us for lashing out from our sense of scarcity and greed, our ignorance and fear. Lead us to a place of repentance, to a desire to do what is right, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with your God. God, we come to you this day with many needs, needs that are as far as across the globe for those who are hurting and afflicted with the suffering and injustice of nations. We see the need in our nation where injustice has been done. God, we pray for healing, for especially the family that has lost a loved one in recent times to injustice. God, we pray for healing of our justice system. We pray, Lord, that you would bring us to a place of a common ground so that all would be seen as people and children of God. We pray for those who march peacefully, for those who commit to being a voice for those who are hurt. We pray, Lord, for those who protect us, for those who keep us safe and who put their lives on the lines so that others will not be harmed. We pray as well for our own personal needs, O God, in this time, for the places we hurt and the places we have hurt others. Forgive us, O Lord. Give us your grace. We pray for those who are homebound, for Dale, the Barnwells, for Liz and Dane, for so many who are not able to be with others. We pray for specific needs for Glenna, for Anne, and for Peg, who are having health concerns. We lift those as well in our prayer list here for the many who have medical uncertainties, who are journeying difficult times. God, give them grace and give them strength and peace and give them your healing. And Lord, we pray and ask all of this in the one who is grace, in Jesus' name, who taught us, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Well, I'm excited to in just a few moments for you to have hear the words from Pastor Luis Martinez from Impacto Ministries. This last year, myself, my daughter, and Diane here from the church were able to go to Guatemala to serve Impacto. And the experience was amazing in so many ways. We sadly are not able to go this year because of all that is going on. And so we wanted to reach out and to have Pastor Luis give us a message today of what is happening in Guatemala with Impacto Ministries. And so this week you have received two mailings, or you will receive them. One is a mailing, a way to support Happy Tummies, which is the children's ministry that we experienced when we were there, kids who have a hunger to know Jesus, and Impacto reaches them, not only feeding their stomachs, but feeding their souls with the love of Jesus. You as well will receive a card from Impacto that allows you an opportunity and a way to support them directly. You can also give your support here through the church in our giving online as well. The ministries are great in through Guatemala, and I'll let Pastor share those with you. But I do want to share one. When we were there, we had the opportunity to help construct a building that they were working on, and you too will have that same opportunity. These blocks will represent your gift as they are building a place for where they can house those students who are learning the Bible, a place where they can teach women in the community how to sew and have a profession, a place where they can instruct and preach on the love of Jesus, and a place where they can house people who come to serve in mission. And it was a place that is called the Promised Land, and I suspect it, hopefully in a couple of years, will be completed. But you have opportunity to support that as well, and that's what these blocks represent. And so as you hear from Pastor Lewis, I would ask that you open your hearts and minds to his message of good news in Jesus.
Hello, everybody. Thank you very, very much for inviting me to be with you, even though through technology today. Please, I apologize, still working in my English. Somebody told me that English is a heavenly language. It's because it takes an eternity to learn it. That means that you need to concentrate a lot in my pronunciation, and I really want to share with you what the Lord is doing in Guatemala. And of course, I'm going to share with you my passion, God's Word. But thank you so much for your prayers and support. God is doing great things. And in 20 minutes, I don't have a time to share with you everything that the Lord is doing. But let me just share with you a couple things that just touched my heart lately, okay? You know that we are in the process of Happy Tummies. Happy Tummies stop because the president in Guatemala locked down the country, and this is why the children can't come to the Happy Tummies places. And we've been thinking and thinking how we can keep helping these children, because even though the quarantine, the virus, but those Happy Tummies can be sad tummies sometimes. But to make it short, the idea came one day to one of the staff members, and it says, how about if we do Happy Tummies to go? If you've been in Guatemala, if you remember those tuk-tuks, this is a three wheels thing. We're thinking to do Happy Tummies to go. That means that the teachers and the cooks are coming every day and wrap the meal and put in a plastic bag, maybe a folder with Bible stories every day. They need to memorize a verse. They need to write, for example, their favorite Bible story or their favorite Jesus miracle. We want to keep them connected with God, with Jesus, and the way. But also, we want to keep those tummies happy. We want to do the same thing for abuelitos too. If you've been in Guatemala, have you heard about abuelitos? If not, Pastor Brian, at the end of this video, is going to explain to you a little more about that. But abuelitos is means grandparents. And we have several grandparents. They have no food to eat. Actually, some of them, their families kick them out and they don't have a place to eat. But we are going to do Happy Abuelitos to go too. Those tuk-tuks, the tuk-tuks will come every day in the morning for abuelitos breakfast. They're going to deliver the breakfast, and they will come back and they will deliver the lunch for, well, almost 400 kids now. Do you know what, church? God is doing great things through you, like through people like you, that you pray, you give, even though in the midst of the crisis. The other beautiful thing is the Bible Institute. This coming Saturday, we are going to continue to restart our Bible Institute. You know that we have 51 students now. 99% of my students in the Bible Institute, they never finished high school. 70% of them, they never finished elementary school. And I told myself, says, if God gave us the opportunity to learn and to study Bible, how about if they can't go to the Bible Institute or the seminary, we can come to them and teach them. Well, it's a long story to make it short. This coming Saturday, we are going to restart classes on Zoom, online. It will be, I am so excited about that. Because my wife is doing a sewing machine. We call the Stitches of Blessings ministry. We have Healing Hands, which is a clinic and a pharmacy. The last thing, then we started 3 Sundays ago. I call this ministry the Church on Wheels. We are sending trucks now, and we put a big speakers in the top of the truck, and the pastor preach from inside the truck. He plays a couple songs in each corner, and then he preach for 10 minutes, and then he moved to another corner, and guess what happened 2 Sundays ago? In one of the corners, one guy came out from the house and he says, Pastor, thank you for that word in the speaker. I really needed to hear it. May I receive Jesus Christ as my personal Savior right now? And he did right there in the street. One of our pastors, we're planting churches, new life churches. And one of our pastors, we moved a new pastor to Zacapa. Zacapa is very hard place to be. I will say in the whole year, 364 days a year, the coldest day in the year can be 90, 95 degrees. Can you imagine March, April? It can be 112, 115. Praise God. God, to God be the glory. God provide a pastor with his wife and a little boy, and we move them to Zacapa to be the pastors there. And I told him, he says, how about if you practice the Church on Wheels too? With $80 every Sunday, we can send trucks to preach the gospel. Right now, we have the money to send 15 trucks. But this last Sunday, listen what happened. Pastor Harvin went to the police station and says, who's in charge of this police station here? And one of the officers says, I am the chief. And he says, hey, chief, I didn't need a special permit to go and preach. Why a special permit? Because the Guatemalan president, he locked down the whole country 24 hours, starting Friday, every Friday at 6 p.m. through Monday at 5 o'clock in the morning on Monday. That means that Saturday and Sunday is locked for 100% of the country. And he says, we know we can't be outside, but I need a special permission to preach the gospel. And the chief says, okay, do you want the permit now? And he says, yes, but I don't have a truck. I need to find a truck first. And the chief of the police says, oh, don't worry. How about if we can use the police truck, the police car? And he says, I will drive. He says, I am a believer. Go in the back and preach the gospel. And I'm going to, I have pictures. Now, maybe we can send you some pictures later when these pastors in the back of the police car preaching the gospel and the whole community and the chief of the police driving the pickup truck preaching the gospel. Please pray that God provide more to send trucks every weekend to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ. And Pastor Brian is going to talk to you about these cards, and also he's going to talk to you about these little blocks that I have in here where we are building things in Guatemala to glorify his name. I have in my hands my favorite book, of course, and John chapter 6 is a beautiful story. John chapter 6 tells us about Jesus and Lazarus, one of his best friends. And let me paraphrase, I don't have a time to read it, but just let me paraphrase what happened. And do you know what? Sometimes it can be funny the things that God do, he has a beautiful sense of humor. But also, we can learn a lot from this. Because sometimes when we talk about crisis versus praying, we have crisis, yes. Everywhere, you turn on the TV, crisis. You turn on the radio on, crisis. You read the newspaper, crisis. You talk to your friend, you talk about crisis. Crisis, the virus, wars, but now Mr. Floyd and many other crises versus answer, versus praying. And do you know what happened? Martha and Mary, they had a huge crisis in their life. Jesus was preaching and they sent somebody to him and talking about praying. Sometimes God, Jesus, answer, even though, listen, the book of Isaiah says sometimes he answer even before we ask. The book of Isaiah says, and I answer before you ask. Sometimes he answer yes immediately. Sometimes he says no immediately. Sometimes he says wait. And listen, I love this when he says wait. Do you know why? Because he always has a good purpose when he says wait. It's not in my time, it's in his time. And Mary and Martha, they had a great crisis, a terrible crisis. Jesus was preaching. They sent somebody to call him. I'm paraphrasing the story for you. And this guy came and says, Jesus, this is an emergency. Your friend Lazarus is dying. And Mary and Martha really want for you to come immediately. And Jesus says, okay, let me check my schedule. Let me check my schedule. And I don't know, no phones, of course, but, oh, do you know what? I have a board meeting tonight, and tomorrow I have a men's breakfast, and then a ladies' lunch. Oh, do you know what? I can come in 4 days. Oh, Jesus, maybe you don't understood correctly. It's now. He's dying. And he says, I can't, but I will be there in 4 days. And do you know what? It was a great purpose in that. The Bible says 4 days later, when he was preaching, says, oh, my friend Lazarus needs to wake up because he didn't pass away. He just fell asleep. And he passed away, of course. And he came. When he came, Martha came to meet him, Jesus, just before he entered into the village. And Martha said to Jesus, and she says, and Jesus, if you had been here, my brother will not have died. And I'm pretty sure that Jesus smiled a little bit, and he says, oh, Martha, it's because I have a better purpose for that. And he says, Martha, how about if you go and call your sister Mary? And she went and says, Mary, the master is right there outside, and he's asking for you. But when everybody noticed that Mary get up and start running out, they thought, oh my goodness, she is going to the tomb to cry. And says, let's go with him to bring comfort to her. And no. And she came to Jesus. And the same thing. And Mary says, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. And Jesus says, hey, Martha, Mary, did I not tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God? I can see two reasons in this beautiful story. When we wait in his time, we can see the glory of God. I'm pretty sure through all these crises in the world, the virus, Mr. Floyd crisis, we will see the glory of God. But do you know what else? Maybe the most important thing, the Bible says, when the big multitude, when Lazarus came back out from the tomb, the big multitude came back, and the Bible says, telling everybody what they have seen and heard. I think that is the reason of the gospel. I think that is the reason when when Jesus is late. It's late for me, but it's not late for him. He always is on time, but sometimes we think that he is late. Well, to God be the glory if he is late, because there is a great purpose behind this late. Hey, church, I really want to thank you again, and just be patient in this crisis, and just keep your eyes open and your ears open, and we will see the glory of God. Did I not tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God? I will pray that you and me, we can see the glory of God through this crisis. Let us pray together. Our Father in heaven, I just want to ask you, as Moses asked you, show me your glory. And Father, through the years, we have seen that you can show us your glory through crisis, through problems, through difficulties. Father, just help us to believe in you and to believe what you can do, and to share with other people that all of this will be for God's glory. In the precious name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. God bless you richly. We love you guys. Thank you.
What a great message and an example of the way to be the church. Could you imagine driving around the city in a truck, in a police vehicle, and sharing the good news of Jesus? In some ways, how far we have come from Jesus' example. He says in Matthew 9, we are told that when Jesus saw the crowds, he looked and he had compassion on them. That is the call of the church, to have compassion on all people and to be and share the love of Jesus to the world, the good news. And I pray that you will do the same, whether it be through serving, supporting ministries like Impacto, or serving and supporting the ministries of Ortonville United Methodist Church, or simply sharing the redeeming love of Jesus to someone you know or someone you meet. God bless you as we sing together this closing song, What a Wondrous Cross.
Survey the soul, my life, my